I feel like I'm not making progress. I'm just not good at learning languages. Speak with a native? No way. I am too scared to. I just feel embarrassed about my poor language skills. I make so many mistakes. It upsets me. Does any of this sound familiar? Is stress and fear preventing you from learning English effectively? Hi guys, Anna English here, and in today's lesson, I want to talk about how stress and fear may be negatively affecting your ability to learn a language. And I also want to discuss how we can change that. It's very well documented that stress, even short-term stress lasting as little as a few hours, can impair brain cell communication in areas associated with learning and memory retrieval, which is why during exams our mind tends to go blank. That's what stress does. Unfortunately, stress is also accepted as a natural part of studying, but this is wrong and it should be rejected. If you are stressed when studying, then it means that something's gone wrong, and that stress will inevitably hinder all of your hard work. So how can we deal with it? Let's start at the beginning, your motivation. To succeed in learning a new skill, you have to be motivated, truly motivated. Now, motivation comes from passion, a strong desire. So what is it that you desire? Do you want to fit into a new community in a different country? Is it your dream to work for an English-speaking company? Are you trying to impress the guy or the girl of your dreams by speaking fluently in their language? Whatever your motivation is, it's important to get a clear understanding of why you're learning in the first place. Visualize what success looks like and use that visualization to drive you. If during this process you realize that actually you are not really that passionate about learning a new language, then perhaps it would be best to think about what you are passionate about and redirect your energies and efforts into a skill that aligns with that passion instead. So your first exercise for today is to pause this video and write in the comments down below, what truly motivates you to learn English? Have a good think about it. Write it down below. I look forward to reading those. Okay, carrying on. Choosing the right method. Now, it's no coincidence that the subjects I succeeded in school were taught by my favorite teachers. These teachers inspired me. They understood my needs and somehow made mundane material more interesting for me. When choosing to self-study, we often just reach out and grab the first resource that comes into sight without necessarily knowing if those resources are suitable for our level or for our learning style. And if there is a mismatch, then learning becomes hard and demotivating. So how can we combat this? Firstly, always try to vary the resources that you use. Focus on getting a resource that leads, so an online course or a language book that leads you through a learning journey. Try and get an additional learning tool, a couple if possible, whether that's apps that support your learning, flashcards, YouTube videos, and also try to get something fun to integrate into your daily life, like a series in your target language, films in your target language, magazines, radio programs, or podcasts in your target language. Now, in choosing those resources, do some research and make sure they're at the right level for you in advance, particularly the leading resource, whether it's an online course or a textbook. Make sure it's the right level for you before you commit financially. Now, many online courses allow you to take a free trial in order to test out that platform to make sure it's right for you. Just like Lingoda, who offer a 1 week free trial, which is 3 free classes. And that's worth taking just to get the free classes. Now, if you're not familiar with Lingoda, they offer interactive curriculum and quite small class sizes. You'll find 3 to 4 students on average in a class with a maximum of 5. But this means that you get the attention that you deserve. Now, Lingoda's classes are offered 24/7, so you can learn languages online where and when you want. So if you're a night owl or if you like to learn during your lunch break, this is the one for you. Now, you can take courses in English, business English, German, French and Spanish, and prices start from only €8 per group class. But even better, you can get a €20 discount on your first month subscription by clicking on the link below and using the voucher code NATIVE10. I've also got really good news for anyone who is motivated by a challenge. Entries for the Lingoda Language Sprint are reopen, and you can still join up until the 26th of June and study for 3 months for free. That means that you can get 100% cash back on your fees if you meet all the requirements, which is basically turning up to all your classes. I'll add my previous video about the sprint in the description below. The only difference now is that you don't have to pay a deposit, you just pay directly for your first month. Lingoda is the number one trusted online language school with 4.6 Trustpilot reviews, and they're very proud to be working with Cambridge Assessment English. Now, click on the link below if you want to find out more. Now, how to become an efficient learner. Okay, so you've found your motivation. You've committed to your methods of learning. But how do you make the most of them and avoid falling into the pit of learning despair? Everyone learns differently, but here are a handful of tips for effective learning that you could try to implement. Number one, little and often. Cramming equals stress, and it's not fun at all. So avoid overloading your brain and burning out by having a set routine of short learning slots. We can all find 15 minutes here and there. So build a learning habit and commit that time to learning. Perhaps it's listening to an English podcast on your way into work, watching a new YouTube lesson after dinner every evening and taking notes, which you then review for 5 minutes before bed. Bite-sized learning can be incredibly effective and will feel less invasive if you have a busy schedule. Number two, speak, speak, speak. Start speaking English from your first week of learning. The longer you leave it, the more frightening the prospect will become. Make it your priority to find a language partner, a friend or a teacher who will regularly speak to you. We have to understand that making mistakes is part of the process and it's okay. So don't be embarrassed. Just find the right person to practice with and start practicing. Number three. Make notes. The most effective students I've taught are those who always make notes when learning. Long-term memories are formed from repetition, and quickly looking at your notes makes revision quick and easy. If you aren't making a note of the new words and phrases you're learning, then you're simply wasting your time. Number four, listen and read at the same time. Many of us lean towards a particular learning style. Some of us learn better through listening, others through seeing, and some through doing. Recognizing and working with your preferred learning style is great. However, Nothing is more effective than a combination of those styles. Inputting the same information through the eyes and ears can be 5 times more powerful than using a single style. So where possible, try to get transcripts to the audios and read along as you listen. Number 5, PMA. This stands for positive mental attitude. When learning starts to feel hard, we often blame ourselves, feeling it's a lack of talent. But this negative perception of ourselves is incredibly damaging to our self-esteem and also to our ability to learn. Now, whatever you believe you can or you can't do it, it's going to come true. The power of the mind is incredible. Now, the fact is that learning languages mostly takes hard work, not talent. So if you feel like you're failing, it's not your fault. It's your mindset or your method or your resources that need to change. Number six, don't just push through. Just like an athlete has to listen to their body, you should listen to your mind. If at some point you start to feel bogged down with information, if you feel like you've hit a wall or you're just tired of one of your resources, then take a break. Find something new. Make learning your hobby, never your chore. Let's talk about external stress. It is inevitable. No matter how prepared we are to be effective learners, we will still have external stresses that can interfere with our ability to learn. So how do we deal with that? Number one, ditch the energy sponge. An energy sponge is something that sucks all the positive energy out of you, leaving you feeling drained and unproductive. Recently, I found spending time scrolling through social media and watching endless news reports to be an energy sponge. Seeing all the negative posts, feeling the overwhelming anger, and the constant doomsday news reports have had a very real impact on my mental and my physical health. For you, it might be an untidy house, a bothersome chore, or even a negative person who is draining you of your energy. The key is to figure out who and what is zapping your energy and try to avoid or address it. Number two, invest in healthy relationships. Closely related to my previous point, the people you surround yourself with can make a huge difference to your life and happiness. Choose positive people who respect and support you, and distance yourself from toxic relationships. Toxic relationships refer to people who make you feel bad about yourself, or the people who just take from you without giving anything back. Now, this can be easier said than done, but the result is well worth the effort. Once you find those great friendships, then be sure to look after them. Be supportive, be respectful to them, make an effort and make time to have fun with those people. And most importantly, know how to resolve differences in a productive way. Number three, look after number one. There are 3 fundamental things our bodies and minds need to be happy. Good quality sleep, a healthy balanced diet, stimulation. Take care of the basics first and foremost. Prioritize sleep. Eat and drink healthily and stimulate your body with exercise and your mind with things that interest you. Maintaining a happy, healthy body should not be an afterthought, but our top priority. Ultimately, we are better versions of ourselves, and life and learning is much easier when we remove the stress. But each of us is different, and we must all find our own ways of managing the challenges we face. Now, I'd love to hear from you about your coping techniques when it comes to stress. How do you relax? What helps you when life gets really stressful? Let's chat about it in the comments below. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you again.